gorgeous. Hi. What's up?
I have an appointment with Megan today.
Hi, Bobby.
Megan, Taylor's here.
She's so cute.
Hi.
So you ready to get tattooed today?
Yes.
Are you gonna get a little portrait of Beatrix, right?
Yeah.
Beatrix Eleanor Longbody is my 4-year-old Chihuahua Jack Russell mix. She's the love of my life.
Where did you want to put it?
I'm thinking back of the leg.
Okay.
I want her to look like a little Victorian lady.
All right. Well, I just need a couple minutes to draw it up.
Okay.
So if you and Beatrix want to go hang out over there on the brown couch.
Okay.
My friend Taylor came in today with her little dog Beatrix, and Taylor wants to get a tattoo of Beatrix, which I think is super cute. We're gonna do it really colorful, really bold, and really cool style. And being one of her really good friends, I'm really excited to do this tattoo on her today.
First tattoo my mother's actually gonna love.
Go ahead and check it out in the mirror.
Bubby's like, what is Meg doing to you, Mom? She's a service dog.
Okay.
So I guess you could say she's prescribed to me. She's prescribed for anxiety.
What do you think started your anxiety issues?
I grew up in Los Angeles in Hollywood, and then my mom moved us to a really small town in Minnesota, and I was pretty much the outcast there. It was a huge change. I was 10 years old. I grew up with a lot of girls that just weren't, you know how girls can be. I wasn't promiscuous like they were. You can only kind of take so much of it. I mean, I started just skipping school and I was going through a really hard time. I tried everything. I mean, they had me on Prozac, they had me on Zoloft, Lexapro. I can't even remember the names of half of them now. I started getting really depressed. My mother didn't really know anything was wrong, and I ended up telling her that I didn't think that I could keep living anymore. And the next morning, she checked me into our local hospital. So my mother said, I want you to meet somebody named Mark. He's a new therapist in town, and he's amazing. And I think he would really help you. He was like, we're gonna try something different. Like, this is pretty new. And at the time, I had just rescued Beatrix, and her doctor and I worked together with her to sort of make her remind me to be calm and remind me that there's a bigger picture.
That's actually a really cool way of looking at it, you know?
Yeah.
When you have a problem, it's all you focus on, and it seems like it's the worst thing in the whole world. But then having somebody like Beatrix there, you know, you realize she depends on you.
Yeah. We live in a Prozac nation, and there's just so many people that turn to that sort of fix. My fix now is Beatrix.
I don't have to take medication, and I don't have to rely on that to be like, oh, you know, your mood's down. Did you take your medication today? It's like, no, my mood's great, because I woke up and my medication was sitting right next to my bed.
All right. I think you're done.
You're done.
Okay. Go check it out.
Meg!
Do you like it?
I love it so much. It looks exactly like her. I love it.
It's definitely my favorite tattoo that I have, and it's honoring my dog who has significantly helped my life. Since I can't tell her that and she won't understand it, all I can do is honor her by having her on my body for the rest of my life.
Can I have a hug for it?
Yes. I feel really good about the tattoo I just did on Taylor. It was totally my style, had complete creative freedom, super colorful. It was a blast.
Bye.
Love you, bye.
Good to see Tim.
Cool, yeah. Cool. What's your name?
John.
John, awesome. Hey, Tim.
Yes.
We have John here for you.
What's up, man?
What's going on, man?
How you doing? Tim.
All right,
nice to meet you.
You too, bro.
What are we doing on you today?
Portrait of my father, my forearm, black and gray, so.
Okay, do you have a picture of
him? Yeah.
Let me see.
This is the original photo I have.
Yeah. Okay, pops. And you want to say Pops?
Yeah, Pops, yeah.
I'm into that.
Right on.
All right, cool.
Thanks a lot, bro.
Yeah, no worries. John wants to get a portrait of his father today. It's a tiny little photo, but there's actually a lot of detail when you scan it in to see it larger. I'm gonna do a really nice job on it. Wanna look in the mirror?
Cool.
Yeah, cool, man.
Two and a half years ago, I opened up a burger spot in Brooklyn. It's called Pops, and it's after my father. You know, my father passed away when I was 19, and he had always wanted to open up a spot. So when I was thinking about the name of the place and kind of like what I wanted to do there, I just really, you know, he was really my inspiration behind it.
Doing okay?
It's doing better than I expected it to do, you know, so.
That's great, man.
My father was an Irish immigrant. He was an alcoholic. and he got sober before me and my brother were born.
He was kind of wild when he was younger, so he didn't really settle down. Not like me.
There you go. I was about to say, at least you know for sure that's your dad.
Definitely my dad, that's for sure, yeah.
I've got the same gene as my father.
Growing up, you know, I was always told, like, it was in our blood, you know? My father used to tell us, we're allergic to alcohol. You know?
Yeah, break out in handcuffs and hospital beds.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is, you know? After he passed away, I definitely got deeper into, you know, my alcoholism. It wasn't because I was, you know, smart enough to realize it or anything like that. I think it definitely was something a little more powerful that said, you know what, man, this is not how you're supposed to be living your life. It's, you know, a lot better things, you know.
If there is such a thing as a God that's looking out for you, I don't feel like I need to be proven that, because my father definitely had to have been like an angel on my shoulder watching out for me.
I'm sober 9 years now. And,
good for you. Yeah. How long was he sober for?
He was actually sober, you know, 20-something years probably by the time he passed away.
Yeah. Man. I don't drink anymore either. Oh, yeah. I don't do it yet. Yeah. Nothing anymore. I'm sober too.
Pops is your local, you know, burgers, wings, cheesesteaks, mac and cheese place. You know, it's just kind of like a homely feel, place to come and connect to your family.
In the restaurant, we got, like, you know, on the pictures on the walls, we'd be like friends and families, fathers and stuff like that, you know? So we'd do that, like old school pictures of friends.
I got a little soft spot for portraits of dads. Literally next to my heart, got my dad's portrait on my chest. Definitely put a little extra in there for him. I would give up everything, my talent, everything, all that stuff, just to have another day and hang out with him, you know?
Yeah, it'd be cool.
But,
you know,
but then he wouldn't want that. He'd be like,
no, of course. He'd be like, what are you, stupid?
Yeah. A little bit of my heart's in this too, you know, because you basically just told my life story right there.
Yeah, right, yeah.
I'm serious.
Yeah.
I've been through all the same stuff. All right, so I know you can see it from here, but you want to go check it out?
It's upside down right now.
Yeah, right?
Damn, yeah. It's amazing, dude.
I definitely credit my father for being the man that I am today, for the lessons he taught me as a child and the lessons that I've learned on my own, him watching over me.
Thank you, man.
Cool. You're welcome, man. Yeah. All right, man.
Later, bro.
All right, have a good night.